Everyone, last class we discussed about operational amplifiers, op amps. We saw summing amplifier, we saw subtraction amplifier, we saw the use of op amp as integrator, we also saw use of op amp as differentiator. Remember, friends, we are discussing various signal conditioning devices. Just to recollect, in a mechatronic system, we have sensor transducers, we have signal conditioning devices, we have display elements, we have control elements, and then we have actuators, and actual task is done. So in that chain of activities, we had just finished last few lectures, we finished the sensor transducer part, then we started with the next stage, that is signal conditioning. And as we discussed earlier, signal conditioning devices, what are the various tasks the signal conditioning devices do? They do amplification, they do comparison, they do conversion, they do filtering, isn't it? Like this, they do various tasks, and then this conditioned signal is sent to either the display unit or to the controller or to the actuator. Now, in this series of various elements in signal conditioning, we'll move a bit further. Let us think of a situation where your sensor transducer has generated some signal. Let us say any thermistor is there, or a thermocouple is there, or a pressure transducer is there. So that transducer is generating certain voltage signal. Now that voltage signal, depending upon the original parameter, will be varying every time. But sometimes, maybe because of malfunctioning or something going wrong with the electronic circuitry, if that transducer will generate abruptly some unwanted signal, or say maybe a surge in voltage suddenly, what is going to happen? Now this transducer signal will be going through the signal conditioning to, let us say, the controller. My case, before the signal goes to actuator, the microprocessor processes this signal. Let us say the microprocessor acts as a controller. Now if this voltage signal which has got sudden surge in voltage, if this signal is sent to a sensitive device like a microprocessor, let us say, or any digital device or any sensitive device which gets affected because of this surge in voltage, what will happen? That device, the controller device, might get damaged. Because these microprocessor-like devices, or many digital devices, they work in the voltage range of maybe 5 to 20 volt DC. And if my transducer is generating the signal suddenly beyond 20 volt, maybe for a moment, what will happen? It will damage my controller elements. It might damage my actuating elements. So I need to just break this circuit in between. If I get this accidentally higher voltage, the circuit is to be isolated, it will be broken, so that this high current and high voltage will not pass on to my sensitive control device. So what we do is we make use of protection circuitries. Now these protection devices, this is the one using a Zener diode. It provides me protection to my remaining circuitry. There are certain opto-isolators which help me in isolating the main circuit from this transducer circuit. So like this, the signal conditioning devices, as we saw in the previous lectures, signal conditioning devices were amplifiers. They amplify the signal, but equally important are the protection elements. So we'll see some of the protection circuitries briefly. So Zener diode as a protection circuit, we'll see. You see, this is the output from the transducers I am receiving. It becomes input to this my protection circuit. And then I have a resistor and I have a Zener diode. So how the Zener diode functions, you can go home and read later on from the books. I'll try to briefly explain to you. This Zener diode has a certain breakdown voltage. Till that point, it acts as a conductor. So beyond a certain breakdown voltage, it will become, or it will behave like a, like an insulator, like it functions as a diode, so one-way current. So how it is going to protect, let us say, the saturation voltage of this Zener diode, or a breakdown voltage for this Zener diode, let us say, is 5 or 5.1 volt. I decide, because it all depends on how much voltage I want to pass on to my next circuitry. Whatever it is, the controller I have, the microprocessor that I have, or a microcontroller that I have, how much voltage that microprocessor or microcontroller or any controller can sustain. I decide this much voltage alone, maximum this much voltage alone should be passed on to the next circuitry. So I can select a diode, Zener diode, of that rating. So let us say if the voltage goes beyond 5.1 volt, this should break the circuit. This Zener diode should break the circuit, so that my rest of the circuitry is protected. So this is one benefit of using Zener diode as a protection element. Zener diode also works, helps in protecting the circuitry from polarity change effects. Suppose by mistake, whatever transducer output I have got, while connecting it to my next device, suppose I have, by mistake, I have changed the polarity, positive to negative, negative to positive. What might happen if it is directly given to the microprocessor or microcontroller, any control devices? It might damage the rest of the circuitry. So if the polarities are changed, and this Zener diode, as it is shown here, so the reverse current, it will not allow. So automatically, it protects the circuitry from polarity reversals. So both ways, the Zener diode works as a protection circuit. Let us briefly see. All these things I have taken from Boulton. Remember, you keep on reading Boulton, very nicely as given. So this extract, because I did not get much time to prepare point-wise PPT. Next class onwards, I'll prepare point-wise PPTs as well. So this is, I just copied it from Boulton's book. And as I repeatedly tell, as I'm telling you repeatedly, Boulton soft copy is also available online. PDF drive, you can just browse through and download the PDF copy of Boulton. And in our library also, we have got copies of Boulton. So which way is preferable, you just get those copies and start reading the books. And these topics require reading. Just my single telling will not be sufficient. You need to read. Okay. So I'll quickly read out. There are many situations where the connection of a sensor to the next unit, that is a microprocessor, can lead to the possibility of damage as a result of perhaps high current or high voltage. A high current can be protected against by incorporation in the input lines a series resistor to limit the current to an acceptable level, and a fuse to break if the current does exceed a safe limit. High voltages or wrong polarity may be protected against by the use of a Zener diode circuit. Just now we saw the circuit by using Zener diode circuit. Zener diodes behave like ordinary diodes up to some breakdown voltage when they become conducting. Up to breakdown voltage, they remain conducting. Thus, to allow a maximum voltage of 5 volt, but stop voltages above 5.1 volt getting through. So beyond 5.1 volt should not pass through to the next unit. A Zener diode with a voltage rating of 5.1 volt might be chosen. When the voltage rises to 5.1 volt, the Zener diode breaks down and its resistance drops to a very low value. The result is that the voltage across the diode, and hence that outputted to the next unit, drops. Because the Zener diode is a diode with a low resistance for current in one direction, through it and a high resistance for the opposite direction. So zener diode as diode has, it works as a conductor once, any diode. In one direction of current flow, it works as conductor. In the other direction, it works as an insulator. Okay, the same thing is written here. Because the zener diode is a diode with a low resistance for current in one direction through it and a high resistance for the opposite direction, it also provides protection against wrong polarity. As I discussed earlier, if the polarity is, while connecting my output from the transducer to the next unit, if the polarities are changed by mistake, you must have experienced this many a times. While if the wire of your earphone is also cut, and if you try to just connect it, and by mistake, if you change the polarity, you're not able to listen. So this is these electronic circuits are very sensitive to polarity changes. Okay, so it provides protection against wrong polarity. So this is how your protection circuit, zener diode based protection circuit, works. We'll go to the opto isolators briefly. These also have the function of protecting the circuitry from high voltages or high currents. Once again, the same thing. The output from my transducer is to be given to the input of my next control unit. Okay. So as we discussed earlier, if high current or high voltages are sent to my next devices, that might damage my microprocessor or any other controller device. So what I need to do is, I need to protect my high-end microprocessor, microcontrollers, or controllers from these voltage fluctuations beyond certain limits. One thing that we have seen is using zener diode, I can protect my devices from voltage beyond certain breakdown voltage. Now the next unit is opto isolators. Now as the name indicates, these are isolators. They isolate the rest of the circuitry. How? By using optical principle. What does it mean? From whatever output I get from my transducer, it is given as the input to my this opto isolator circuitry. Okay, so I make use of LED and the intensity of light emitting diode. The intensity of light is dependent upon the voltage across it and the current flowing through it. As the voltage and current, these increase or decrease, accordingly the intensity of light also will increase or decrease. So in the, on the other side, what I have got, a transistor, a photo sensitive transistor. Okay, so these photodiodes or phototransistors, so to say, they will act based on the light intensity of light that is falling, that is the infrared rays, those are falling on these transistors, because these are optically or light sensitive transistors. So beyond a certain value of voltage or current, if I want to have isolation of my microprocessor or any other digital device, what happens is, up to that certain voltage, the LED will be having certain value of brightness or certain value of infrared rays, certain value of optical rays. So beyond that intensity, what will happen? These phototransistors, based on, let us say, 5 volt input, if my limiting voltage is 5 volt, so corresponding to 5 volts and some designated current, I'll be having particular intensity of light. Depending on that intensity of light, this transistor circuitry will be generating some voltage or current. So that will be the limiting value. Okay. So once the intensity of light increases, why the intensity of light will increase? Because the voltage supplied to that circuit is increasing. So what will happen? The light intensity will increase. As the light intensity increases, the voltage generated across this transistor also increases. So, and this in turn will control my original circuitry. If the voltage developed by this phototransistor crosses my limiting value, accordingly I'll have a relay which will stop the supply to the next unit. Okay, so this is how your transistor based photo isolators or opto isolators are working. Similarly, I have Darlington pair of transistors. Okay, this is Darlington pair, you can read at home. I have two transistors instead of one. They also do the same work. and the intensity, the output from these transistor circuitry is dependent on intensity of light that is falling on these transistors, and intensity of light is dependent upon the voltage that is supplied across this LED. Then I have triac based. The principle is same, only the units are different. Then triac with zero crossing unit. We need not get into the details of this circuit currents and all the analysis in this case. Only thing is that we should know what is the function of opto isolators and how they are useful to me in my mechatronic circuitry. So briefly, we'll see in situations where it is desirable to isolate main circuit. Main circuit means what? My transducer, my controller, my actuators. This is my main circuitry. Where it is desirable to isolate main circuit completely and remove all electrical connections between them, opto isolators are used. Why need to isolate the connections? Just to protect the rest of the circuitry. Okay, and I decide till what value the voltage drop is permitted, to what value the current rating is permitted, and based on that I provide this isolating circuit. Based on the voltage in the circuit, the LED emits infrared radiation. This radiation is detected by phototransistor or triac. The current in the external circuit is used to regulate or protect main circuit. Opto isolator outputs can be used to directly to switch low power load circuits. In case of high voltages, output current from opto isolator is utilized for disconnecting the power supply to the circuit, and thus the circuit gets protected. What does this mean? Either on the output side, I have one more relay circuit and then it is doing the work of making or breaking the main circuit one way, or I design this output circuitry in such a way that it directly connects or disconnects my main circuitry. That is what this last point is saying. In case of high voltages, output current from opto isolator is utilized for disconnecting the power supply to the circuit, and thus the circuit gets protected directly. So no need of another relay circuit as such. So this is how the Zener diode based protection circuits are used and opto isolator protection circuitries are used. Let us move further. This is one more function of my signal conditioning device. What is that function? It is filtering of the signal. Whatever signal I am getting from my sensor transducers. See, what happens is, it's not the case that I have my control device right next to my mechatronic unit. It might so happen that in my IC engine lab, I have all the sensors and transducers that are mounted. And sitting in my room, in my cabin, I want to control. I want to monitor the functioning of that IC engine lab. So in that case, what happens is that signal needs to be transmitted over long distance. Okay, well, you should have the signal strength, appropriate signal strength, then only it is possible. This might appear to be a very long distance. Let us say that in the IC engine lab, the control unit is in the cabin of the teacher, and the circuit is, the main sensing circuitry is near the engine. So the signal that is sensed, maybe the speed, torque, whatever, mass flow rate, fuel flow rate, air flow rate, the sensors are sensing all those parameters. And I have maybe a computer next to me wherein I have the control software. So my computer processor is acting as the controller, because the computer processor is nothing but a microprocessor, isn't it? A high-end microprocessor. So what I'm trying to tell you is that the signal that is sensed at the device, the engine is constantly running. There are some electromagnetic units nearby. There is a starter, there is a dynamo, there are some other units. So what happens is, this signal, let us say one temperature signal is picked up by a thermocouple or a thermistor. So that thermocouple will convert the temperature signal into voltage signal. So that signal is picked up, that low voltage signal, maybe it is amplified and then it is given to my processor. So because of the adjacent units, because of the environment factors, it might pick up some stray magnetizing currents in the surrounding. So along with my main voltage signal, there'll be some picked up traces of sinusoidal current, maybe AC current. So some other magnetizing current. So the signal will not be a pure signal, transduced signal. It will have certain impurities or some unwanted signals along with it. And those signals are called as the noise signals. Noise does not necessarily mean the sound noise. A polluted signal, let us say, or a distorted signal, let us say. So such signals, along with my pure transduced voltage signal, some other unwanted signals are also coming to my processor. So those might affect the performance of my mechatronic system, because the next stage is processing of that transduced signal and generate one actuating signal. If I don't filter out the noise components in my original circuit, original signal, I might propagate or transmit this noise-based signal to my next unit, which is not desirable. So I might not get appropriate control of the actuating device, isn't it? So for that purpose, these unwanted signals or noise signals should be filtered out. So this is one more function of my signal conditioning devices. So I need to have, and we are talking about electronic filtering circuits. Okay. So output signals from sensors contain noise due to various external factors like improper hardware, environmental effects, or some magnetic material surrounding it, or some other electrical circuitry surrounding it. So my original transducer signal might contain some noise signals. This noise gives an error in the final output of the system. Therefore, it must be removed from the transducer. Whatever transducer signal is getting transmitted, the noise signals should be filtered out. In practice, change in desired frequency level of output signal is a commonly noted noise. So this is one form of noise signal. Change in desired frequency level of output signal. So I am receiving a continuously varying sinusoidal signal, let us say. That sinusoidal signal is having original frequency. Okay, whatever radians per second frequency or whatever is the frequency unit, that signal may be a voltage signal, whatever electrical signal, the transducer signal is moving with certain frequency. And along with this original signal, I have some unwanted signals having different frequencies. And those frequencies are getting attached to my original frequency, original waveforms. And depending on at what frequencies I'm having the noise signals, at what frequencies I'm not having the noise signals, accordingly, I can design my filters. And what I do, either I have the signal filtered out, maybe only at low frequency levels, I have more noise. So I filter out the signal accordingly. At high frequency levels, I have noise signals. Accordingly, I have the filters designed for that. Or maybe in a continuous sinusoidal signal, I have only small frequency band along with I have got the noise signal. Okay. So based on the nature of the noise signal that is attached to my original signal, I select the filters. So based on the nature of the noise signals attached to my original signal, either I go in for a low pass filter, or I go in for high pass filter, or I use band pass filter. What is the meaning of low pass filter? Low pass, passage only for lower frequencies. Higher frequencies I don't allow. High pass filter, passage only for higher frequencies. The frequencies lower to those higher frequency band are rejected. So band pass filter, lower and higher, I allow. Only the passage of frequency band in between, only that is allowed. And the low and high frequencies are rejected. So that is band pass filter. Or band reject. Lower and higher are allowed. The in between band of frequencies is rejected. So depending upon which portion of a continuous signal I want to allow to go to my next level, I design a filtering circuit accordingly. And we will be studying this low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, or band reject filter. So these are the few filtering circuits we are going to study. Remember, I repeatedly keep on telling, we are not here to design a new filtering circuit. Here we are being mechanical engineers, being mechatronics engineers. We should know what is the function of filtering circuits, why those are required, and what function they do. So this is what is required. This knowledge is required. We need not going for design of a filtering circuit, but this basic knowledge we must have. Okay, so in the next class, we'll study each type of filter, circuitry. Well, we need to write few equations also, if required, and then we'll evaluate the function of each filtering circuit. So for today, we shall stop. Today we discussed zener diode based protection unit, opto isolators, type protection unit, and then we just started with filtering circuit. What is the function of filtering circuit? Why it is required to filter out the noise signals? And we have just enlisted the filters: low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, and band reject filter. So friends, we'll stop for today.